Hey guys, you're with me, Kevin, your scuba professional. And today we're here to have a quick look at the differences between the new Garmin Mark II and the Garmin Mark IIi. I've been fortunate enough to be fiddling around and playing around with these guys for the past few days to try to figure out the differences, quirks, and nuances. And the first thing I can tell you is the only real difference between the Mark IIi and the Mark I is the fact that the Mark IIi has the titanium bezel and is milled from titanium, and the standard Mark II has a stainless steel bezel and has stainless steel inner workings, and the Mark IIi has transmitter capability. So the Mark IIi now working with Garmin's new T1 transmitter that works on the new subwave technology. New subwave being to diving, subwave technology used by Garmin and all their boating technology for many years, which has now just been adapted for use with the Garmin Mark IIi. The Mark II, however, you'll notice, doesn't have transmitter capability. But other than that, it does exactly the same as the Mark IIi. It's got all the same functionality from a dive point of view. Both of them do normal diving, nitrox diving. They do CCR and full tech trimix, as well as apnea freedive. And I really like the freedive or apnea hunt modes that both of these units have that turns off the vibration and the alarm. So if you are doing deeper free dives, it won't alert any of the marine life around you. But let's dive on in to take a closer look at these two units so we can pick up the cosmetic differences as well. So the first thing we can see as far as these units are concerned is from a shape point of view, they are absolutely identical. The Mark II has a stainless steel bezel and the Mark IIi has the titanium bezel around the outside. So the titanium has a slightly darker look, but from a shape point of view, they are both exactly the same. If we turn them over, we can see that the titanium has the titanium backing, the standard Mark II with the stainless steel backing, but the heart rate monitor ports are exactly the same, and so are the charging ports. If we turn the units to the side, you can see that from a thickness point of view, exactly the same, the only differences being the buttons. I quite like the fact that the Mark IIi has these little blue accents around the titanium button, the standard Mark II just having the standard stainless steel buttons. On the side, you can see the three buttons there as well. But overall, if you were to compare the two, they look very, very similar. The only nuances just being the different colors on this side and on the back side. The straps are the same and they both come with the extension strap itself. From a functionality point of view, on the internal workings of these units, they are absolutely identical from their navigation ports with points, which we've done in a different video, which you can see linked up below. We take you through all the navigation menus within this unit, but you'll see they're all identical with the exception of one function on this unit where you can sync it up with the Garmin TR transmitter for the air transmitter technology. So overall, those are the only differences, just from a slight cosmetic point and then the transmitter itself. Now that we've had a closer look at the units themselves, you can see there's really not much in it. From the cosmetic point, there's just the ever so slight nuances as far as the bezels are concerned. The main difference between them being the Mark IIi having the transmitter capability. The third time I've said that in this video, I know, but that quite often is the make or break as far as divers are concerned, because all divers like those little goodies that will put them apart from anyone else. And air technology and integrated air technology is quite a cool little gadget to have. But overall, just looking at the units, we need to weigh up the costs. The Mark IIi with the transmitter scraping close to 40,000 South African rands, and the standard Mark II at just under 30,000. We're looking at a hell of a lot of money for these units. But we need to keep in mind that they are not just dive computers. They are full multi-sports and smartwatches. smartwatches with dive computers built into them. Not just any dive computer, we've already mentioned that it's air, Nitrox, FreeDive, CCR, completely closed rebreather, and full tech Trimix technology built into both of these units. So which one should you buy? Well, that's completely up to you. If you've got the choices between a sports watch and a dive computer, so you already have a multi-sport watch and you're just looking for a dive computer, well, this is a really big ask to jump up to go to. However, if you are at a point where you are buying a smartwatch and multi-sports watch, or you are finished with your older version and you're now looking to upgrade your lifestyle sports watch and looking for a dive computer, well, then there's no question that the Mark IIs are by far the most advanced and best equipped units for you on the market today. These dive computers, keep in mind, are like a full Garmin Fenix 6 with dive technology built into them. So on these units, you have every single sport you can possibly think of, from your running, gym, cycling, swimming, open water swimming, hiking, stand-up paddling, skydiving. The list is endless and upgraded on an ongoing basis. Also really funky in the fact that it's got now Garmin's music. So you've got all the music that you can load onto here, which you can listen via your wireless headphones while you're out doing any form of activities. You've got Garmin Pay technology built in here, as well as your full GPS technology as well for all your sports. And you can even go and mark your favorite dive sites as far as your entry and exit points are concerned. So overall, from that point, I would recommend the Mark IIs if you are looking to upgrade your lifestyle watch. The question now is, do you go for Mark II or Mark IIi? It's quite a price jump between the two, and this is where you need to decide. The more serious divers, funnily enough, that work more with the CCR and Tektronix, normally don't use the transmitters. They much prefer the analog gauges on their cylinders. Otherwise, you wind up with multiple switching on your unit to go from gas to gas to gas to gas, which increases your task loading quite a bit. So you need to decide then, if you are at that level and you're never going to use this technology, is it worth spending that amount of money? So from that instance, the standard Mark II is going to work just as well for you. If you're one of those divers that really wants the gadgets and really likes the information, the Mark IIi with the transmitter is obviously the right choice. More expensive, we know, but it is really, really cool to sit after a dive and brag to your mates about your sack rate. Sack rate? Surface air consumption rate. We all know that the calmer the diver, the less air they use. And this little guy with the combination of your transmitter is going to give you all those performance matrices. So you can tell what your heart rate is, your breathing rate, your stress levels. All of that can be analyzed down in your Mark IIi with the transmitter built in. So begs the question, which one do you get? I know from my side, because I've just bought one myself, this is the unit for me. The Mark IIi with the transmitter. Why is that? Because I dig my gadgets. I dig knowing what my sack rate is. And just as I said a bit earlier, when you pull up at a robot in your brand new BMW and the guy next to you's got the M package on it, you know the difference. And the same goes for this. If you've got the Mark IIi, you can tell the difference from the titanium bezel and those really cool blue accents that are around all the buttons. Plus, air transmitter technology. I dig that. So this is my choice. The Garmin Descent Mark IIi is for me, and we've now reviewed the differences. If you guys are enjoying the product reviews, please feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel or go check out our social streams, the main one being facebook.com/scuba.co.za. I'll keep you up to date with all the funky things that we've got going on an ongoing basis. So that's it from me, guys, and I look forward to seeing you with me out in the water with my Mark IIi titanium dive computer really soon.